tonight in our main event on DAZN. 12 rounds, super middleweight division. Todd Grisham, Sergio Mora, Chris Mannix, and Barry Jones ringside. Barry, what does John Ryder have to do in the early rounds? Go ahead, Barry.
For me, he has to try and take that center of the ring. Munguia likes to do that, likes to come forward. But if you can just steal the center of the ring, just maybe try and make him think about the defense for a little bit longer than usual. That'll give you some forward momentum, do some good work.
I think the blueprint is already there. Start fast on Munguia, back him up, get him on his back foot. He's not the fastest footed fighter, so if you can get him on his heels, just like Derevchenko did from the first round, that's how you start getting Munguia uncomfortable early. Well, Ryder could do that.
Look at the size of Ryder's legs. He is a gorilla.
Yes, he is. Strong, compact fighter. I mean, I sized him up, and yeah, he's definitely a super middleweight.
And I was saying earlier, he's a more intelligent fighter than people give him credit for as well. So he will be thinking about his work. I think it's important that every time Munguia throws a single shot, Ryder has to attack.
Nice right hand and a left from Munguia. Ryder, as you mentioned, Barry, trying to throw between the punches.
See that Ryder's already having Munguia on the back foot. You know, Munguia's backing up himself, looking for the right shot, but this is something that we're not accustomed to seeing. Normally, Jaime Munguia is the one on the front foot, getting really aggressive, looking for openings and body shots.
Sits on the back foot, and that makes it hard for you to reach through that first jab. But when you commit to your attacks, he has nowhere else to go there, Ryder. He's sat on that back foot, he has to sit down and take the shot.
Ryder's looking to time Munguia with a big left hand, but Munguia's punching really fast. He's not concentrating on power right now. He's doubling, tripling the jabs, coming up with a straight right hand. Really smart behind Munguia in his first round.
Hey, Munguia's already complaining about Ryder. That's a good thing, though, Barry, right? You want to get under his skin.
Yeah, but I think that's important. You've got to try and stunt that work that he does. You want to stop it early.
Nice telling round. Beautiful shot right there going around the elbows of Munguia's body. You're going to see a lot of more body shots there by Ryder. Nice straight hand by Munguia coming around the right hook of Ryder. Beautiful shot by Munguia. Nice opening round where both men got their shots.
Straight back into the action. For the record, John Ryder has only been stopped once. That was back in 2015 by Nick Blackwell for the vacant British middleweight title.
And it was a premature stoppage. It was a fight that he was winning. So technically, Ryder's really never been convincingly knocked out by anyone in 38 fights.
Munguia told us this week is that looking back and reflecting on the Derevchenko fight, he felt like he was a little bit too overeager, and that resulted in him just letting his hands go for 12 rounds.
Left hand over the top jab there is also a right, which makes it a little bit difficult for Ryder to counter there.
This may be the first time. Oh, good right hand there from Munguia. Caught him again.
a straight shot. He set that up by bending his knees. Munguia caught him clean with that straight right hand.
And we're going to find out what John Ryder is made of in a situation like this. One of my concerns was that after a fight against someone like Canelo, do you still have that same hunger?
You can bet Ryder's going to punch in between the shots. He's sure. He's shook up right now, but he's going to keep punching.
Go ahead.
Trying to hold on desperately is Ryder.
Now you see Ryder coming with the right hook. Two right hooks right there.
Got him again with a right hand, did Munguia.
There's three right hooks by Ryder. That's the thing about Munguia. When he has opponents hurt, he throws caution to the wind and doesn't move his head. He's just as vulnerable as his opponent.
And we talk about Munguia's, he can recover really quick. But Ryder also has can recover quite quick, as we saw against Canelo. And the pressure, he will fire back.
Ryder has the experience that when he's hurt, he's going to take advantage of the over-aggression of his opponents.
Whoa, a swing and a miss. Munguia putting everything behind these shots. And there's Ryder, that right hand scores.
I think there's more thought to Munguia's work as well. He's still being busy, but he's thinking about where the target is and he's aiming for it rather than just letting his punches go unabandoned.
I think Munguia's loading up a little bit too much, and that's what happens when you drop your opponent. He should be going back to what dropped him, and that was a clean setting up the jab with a clean right hand.
Whoa, stop! Whoa!
This crowd's still on their feet. Ryder's handled the pressure pretty well. But Munguia wants another knockdown here in the second. Great start for Munguia.
Did he catch a flush though, or is it just a fresh one?
It's a fresh one, yeah.
Yeah, you didn't look good, mate. Listen, you're catching him with that right hook when he comes in now.
Yeah.
Yeah? So what are you going to do when he comes in, hit him with a right hook, left up, right hook, yeah?
Munguia beautiful right there, setting him up with that right hand. Not smothering his attack, keeping the range right on the money, and he caught him on the right side of the chin. Southpaws aren't accustomed to getting hit on that right side. Fights clean right hand, and here's the onslaught against the ropes. Just beautiful shots, but you know what? Credit to Ryder for smothering that attack, turning his opponent,
second
putting
down.
Munguia on the ropes.
Second down.
That shows the strength of John Ryder right there, but he can't keep getting punched by those shots so clean this early.
Right hook. That's what John Ryder's corner kept saying. We're going to get him with the right hook.
And that's the punch that I said that was going to be his money punch. The left uppercut and right hook. Don't stand in front of Munguia too long. That punch will be there.
But the way Munguia is sliding into the target and taking that foot on the outside, if Ryder wants to throw that left hand, he has to square his shoulders up then, and that just gives him a real clean target to hit, and that's why that right hand did so much damage.
I like that right hand that Munguia's been throwing to the body. That's actually setting up the headshot, but he's doing it in a responsible manner, bending his knees. There it is again.
That's right on the belt line.
Something that Freddie Roach has drilled into Jaime Munguia. Don't be afraid to go a little bit low, whether it's on the hip or on the belt line. Use the entire body.
I love hearing that. Even if they warn you, don't stop going to the body.
Good shot there from Ryder. Nice little left hand.
Ryder trying to inch his way back into this after going down in round two.
Nice little bounce on the toes of Munguia, which we're not accustomed to seeing.
Oh, nice uppercut there by Ryder.
He's on his toes, bouncing, looking for a nice right counter shot. I mean, Munguia is. Look at that. Feeling it.
Dipping to the left there, Ryder, coming back. If he can just dip to the right and try and slide forward, there's a gap there if that left hand goes through the middle.
I love the ring generalship by John Ryder. He's never against the ropes. He's always turning into the middle. Anytime he gets near the ropes, notice how he pivots out and then goes right back to the middle of the ring. Here he goes. See that?
They're going to call it. No, wait. They're going to. No. Boy, he thought about it, didn't he? He thought about it, but that would be ruled not a knockdown.
Well, there was a shot from Jaime Munguia that landed right on the right hip of John Ryder.
nice shot there by Ryder. Touch on both sides.
He's just getting a little bit too close there, Munguia. He can throw from longer out. Doesn't need to get that close.
The straight right hand has been the best punch for Munguia. The right hook, the best punch for Ryder.
And then you see Ryder again. Once he got near the ropes, pivoted away, went right back to the center of the ring.
Oh, good shot from Ryder. Lovely right hook.
That's the one he wants, isn't it?
That's going to be the main punch. It's the right hook. And the more aggressive that Munguia is looking for the knockout, looking for the big punches, the more vulnerable he's going to be for that right hook.
But every time he throws a single shot, he's got to make the most of it, Ryder.
Right there, set up by an uppercut, but it was the foot position that got him in there. Good body shots, and that's what I want to see more from Munguia, of course, because that's how he breaks down opponents. Heavy body shots. Ryder's not the type to catch and shoot, catch and counter, so take advantage of that, keep digging away.
Look. 1-2 to start the round for Jaime Munguia, and another right on the chin. It's been an action-packed affair so far as we're in the fourth.
Munguia's getting really aggressive right here. Came out with a hard 1-2 and came around the guard with a right hook.
Stop. And he really steps in with that jab as well, doesn't he? Gets all the power in that left hand. He's
working all his power into that shot.
Good head movement there from John Ryder, just making him miss by an inch.
Still trying to set up that right hook. It's a catch, Munguia coming in.
Let him go! Let him go!
Work punches out. Landed through shot, round shot. Three. 42 for Munguia, 22 for Ryder at the same percentage.
All right, let's go. Buck.
Chris, we knew Munguia was going to throw more punches. No surprise.
No surprise. His activity is always the big difference maker. How John Ryder found a way to either match it or compensate for it is still the open question.
I think Munguia respects the size and strength of John Ryder. You can see that he's a muscular guy, and you can see when they clinch, he actually maneuvers.
Big right hand. Ryder just leaning back on those ropes.
Nice counter left there by John Ryder.
I'll tell you what, Munguia landed a good left hand to the body. I don't know if it caught the attention of Ryder.
Nice jab from Ryder.
Because Ryder will always fire back, when Munguia has an attack like that on the ropes, you just got to take a little angle, just a little quarter turn, and then fire again.
A little momentum shift here.
Slower pace favors John Ryder.
Lovely. Fantastic jab.
Tried that right uppercut, countered, didn't quite catch him. Do you feel like he's settled down? Oh, and he's dead! Speaking of settled down, he gets knocked down for the second time.
Listen to what I'm saying to you now, right? You've got to back this kid up, yeah?
Yeah.
You don't go backward, you're a lot stronger than him.
Yeah.
Right? If he jumps at you, you gotta take a step back. You gotta start backing him up. Don't want you to take a backward step now for you. It's marching down there, John. He's had two knockdowns on you. That means he's 6 rounds up already. Yeah. We've only done 4 rounds, mate. You got to, listen, back him up now. Start banging away, body and head. Come on, John.
They see Jaime Munguia setting him up for that straight right hand. Ryder should not be in the... There's the body shot that I seen Munguia land on Ryder. Ryder took that well. Right there, but it was a punch.
Didn't seem like much to it, Barry.
No, I think, but John Ryder just squared his feet up, so he didn't have the balance to just absorb the shot there. But a knockdown's a knockdown. There's a big deficit here for Ryder to come back from.
Absolutely. Dropped in the second and in the fourth. And Munguia, full of confidence and vigor.
We're coming there. Let him go, John!
Especially because he's so poor, an orthodox fighter. The guy coming forward is going to have the advantage to get that foot, slide that foot on the outside and have more angles of attack. So for Ryder, he's got to try and somehow just get, take that centre ring and just try and push Munguia back a little bit more if he can.
Right hand lands for Munguia. There's a right from landing from Ryder, and there's a left from Ryder, but he took one as well.
Now Ryder's getting the worst of it in the inside. Yes, he's exchanging bravely, but Munguia's catching him cleanly.
He's rolling the dice, Barry, because he has to, doesn't he?
Yeah, but that right hand really dipped the legs there to John Ryder. He had to ask a lot of questions of himself.
John, let him go. No, he's rolling the dice, and he's definitely throwing caution to win, but right now it's favoring Munguia a little bit more.
I think Munguia has been the most controlled I've seen him.
Good right hand, a crushing right, and John Ryder's got to find something quick.
Just like seeing Munguia double up with that left hook. Just finish off with the head after he lands that body shot.
Munguia trying to be patient.
Good right hand to the body there from Munguia.
Ryder said, I have to use my ring generalship. That's how I win this fight. Have you seen any of that, Barry?
Well, he's trying to draw him out by sitting on the back foot, but the length of Munguia, the way he punches long, I just think Ryder struggled with that. He's still been able to land with his counter shots. He's having to take the brunt of that right hand way too often.
I've seen some ring generalship. I like the way Ryder's staying off the ropes and always going back to the middle of the ring.
Half minute to go here in round five. Ryder took it well for what that's worth.
Ryder's been taking these punches, but he needs to come back with something. Anytime Munguia's letting them hands go, you gotta come back just like that.
Returns for his first fight of 2024, taking on former WBC super lightweight challenger Jose Zepeda. That's live on DAZN Saturday, March 23rd.
There's a nice jab, a beautiful left hand timed by Ryder. Munguia's looking for the right, big right hand coming around the guard now. Right hook lands. John Ryder's right hook misses. Really good round by Munguia, but I love the patience. Barry, you touched on it. This is the patience side of Jaime Munguia.
Yeah, it's the most thoughtful I've seen of him. He's not just swinging those shots thinking, I'm powerful, I'm going to walk for your punches. He's trying to make Ryder miss, but most importantly, he's punching long. That's what's causing Ryder all the trouble.
I agree. I mean, this is the most composed I've seen Jaime Munguia, especially since he's already been successful with 2 knockdowns.
Round 6, scheduled for 12. Another right up
uppercut from the Mexican.
If you look at their feet, there's another fight going on below the waist here. They're trying to get their foot on the outside, tangling up almost.
I say that all the time, Baron. These guys never see it, but I'm glad you pointed that out.
Good right hook stepping in there for Ryder as we send it to Chris Mannix in Jaime Munguia's corner.
Freddie, how do you feel the first half of the fight went?
Pretty well. Yeah, he landed some good shots, trying to get down a couple of times. But he hasn't got him out of there yet, but he needs to turn it up a little bit, I think.
What do you want to see him do to turn it up?
He used more jabs and more right hands to the body. He's trying to let the guy tie him up a little bit too much.
Nice, Freddie.
What a shot. Freddie wants more offense, Sergio.
Yeah, either no, but it was a smart offense, more jabs. And I agree. You know, Munguia needs to set up that power with more jabs because Ryder's looking for counters. And Ryder started off good in this round.
Yeah, good job there again there from Ryder.
Yeah, sweat flying off the head of Munguia. But we know how tough his chin is.
Good work there from Ryder. Stuck in the corner there. Got himself out to that.
Yeah, don't expect to hurt Munguia, but you can hit him. He is hittable, so concentrate on points.
Having a good little spell here, isn't he, John Ryder?
Yes, he is.
Got him again, halfway through round six. Yeah, that straight right hand is deadly. There it is to the body.
Oh, stop!
And even if you can take those right hands, they just drain your tank. Yeah, they tire you out really quickly.
Well, against Canelo, Ryder closed strong. He absorbed all the punishment and had a good little spell at the end of the fight. Let's see if he kind of grows into this match as well.
Maybe a little bit too long here, Munguia, to pull the trigger. He's allowed Ryder to get some good work into play.
But would you like to see Ryder coming forward, being more aggressive, controlling the ring now? As he's starting to do that, it seems.
Yeah, I think you know, if you've got the center of the ring, you've got a lot more space to work. You can slide your foot on the outside, you've got a chance to get that left hand into play.
I think he's doing it in this round. I think Ryder's having a good round. He has a good right hand right there, but he's been pushing Munguia back, and then he shot like that.
Good stiff right jab from Ryder. This is his best round.
Yes, it is, and he's growing confident.
Lovely right choke there from Ryder. A fantastic little round here.
To the body first and into the edge. See the backhand, what I was telling you about? Can't miss him with that straight backhand, John. You know what I mean? You got to start bringing that left hook in.
And here we see John Ryder, you know, coming in with a jab. This is the best round so far for him. Nice 1-2 from that left-handed stance. Very calm and cool. Beautiful shot right there. See, that's
under the arm.
That's a southpaw advantage, and that's the fact that a compact, shorter fighter took advantage of going under the arm of the jab of a lazy jab of Munguia.
And you see that shot because he bent low, he bent his knees low, and you got when you look up, you got a better angle of the opponent, of the target, and then you can slip that shot through the middle.
Second and fourth.
Let him go! Let him go! Let him go, John! Let him go! Let him go! Let him go!
It's so important here that Ryder builds on the success of the last round.
No more holding, okay?
He's going to give some momentum. If he loses this round, he's going to get some momentum back. It's a really hard task for him.
Little short right on the inside for Ryder as he tries to tie him up.
There it is again.
Look out, let him go, John!
Nice right hook. Three right hooks landed by Ryder. That's four. You find a home for the right hook. That's his money punch right there. And that's the punch that I think can continue landing on Munguia. Munguia keeps his head in the same place. He doesn't really move it that much.
I don't know why he's getting so close here, Munguia. You've got to come behind the punches. Punch long and then step in behind them.
John Ryder seems to be getting his timing down, Sergio.
Yes, you saw that too. That was a well-timed shot. He waited for Munguia to throw that double jab in with that right hand, and then he countered him with a left hook. That was all timing on Ryder's part. See, when Munguia's not punching, you know, that's when you should be attacking if you're John Ryder. Just like right there, look, he's not punching, that's when you attack. Munguia's either all offensive or he's not doing anything. Right here is exactly when John Ryder should be taking advantage of the offense.
And even if you're not throwing, just steal the space with that front foot.
There, seems like that. Just keep pushing it back. There's another good round by John Ryder. He's had his moments.
Maybe Munguia's just trying to maybe take the round off or take half the round off. Recharge the batteries a little bit.
Maybe he's taking a round off, yeah. Because he's had so much success in the first half of his fight.
Well, this is your two rounds in a row then that he's taken on. I thought he lost the sixth round. He was on his way to lose the second.
No, the sixth round, John Ryder earned it. This one, Munguia, seems like he's taking off.
But again, because the output's not there from Munguia, those single shots are 1-2s, Ryder can work off that. It's very hard to counter off a 30 or 4 or 5 hard shots. You can do it off a 1 or 2 punch combination. And he's done it in this round again here, John Ryder, for me.
Just like tonight, it promises to be a special night on Saturday, March 2nd, as Amanda Serrano makes her homecoming by headlining the bill in Puerto Rico with the problem child and promoter Jake Paul as the co-main event. Live and exclusive March 2nd on DAZN.
Straight,
Ryder, you know, coming around the guard. Nice hook, but it looks like it landed on the shoulder. Both of them exchanging hooks. You see Ryder got a little angle on him. That's what the southpaw has an advantage on. It was a good round by John Ryder.
You see the corner of Jaime Munguia. Freddie Roach is there, but he does have a thinned out staff around him. Marvin Simodio, his longtime assistant, he's working another car tonight. And Pepe Riley, who's a big part of this training camp. He actually had to go home today because he was feeling sick. So still Freddie Roach's corner, but not the same usual team around him.
And Ryder trying to time a big left uppercut right there.
Let's see if Munguia picks up the pace after feasibly losing the last two rounds.
Yeah, a bit wild there wasn't even Munguia, and it was easy for Ryder just to land with a shot and slip out the distance.
And I like the punch selection that Ryder's doing. He's trying to time Munguia coming in with an uppercut. There it is again.
Shot. There's a right for Munguia, who's pushing the tempo. Oh, and almost a knee touching for Ryder.
And that first right hand is what John Ryder's still reacting to.
Oh, he clipped it big again. The referee taking a look at Ryder.
Ryder better clinch. He's getting hit too cleanly by a big puncher, Munguia. Yeah, you can tell Ryder doesn't have his feet under him. He's shook. Big right hook by Ryder.
That's the one Ryder been setting up. And now it's Munguia holding on a little bit.
Ryder's the type of guy who's going to go down swinging, so he's always going to be dangerous.
But he needed that shot there. That just stopped the work, didn't it, Munguia, automatically?
Yeah, he did. Munguia got rocks on that one.
It was like a light switch. Turned off the offense.
And now Ryder's going to be offense on the offense.
Did a lot of work there. Munguia real tired there, trying to get the finish.
Stop. 30 seconds ago, Ryder looked like he was about to be stopped. Now he's the man pushing forward.
A little left hand go there, Ryder.
Ryder keeps throwing that left uppercut. That's a sneaky punch, and if it lands, it's going to do damage on Munguia.
Ryder got to dip his legs low and just throw that left hand over the top. Faint low, punch high.
I like the rough tactics by Ryder now. He's trying to push back Munguia. A little bit of wrestling. He's a naturally bigger man. He should actually start using that, imposing his size on Munguia. Just like that. See, Munguia can't counter on the back foot.
He's drawn Munguia into a distance where he's not as effective.
To see Jaime Munguia against John Ryder. We just saw John Ryder eat a big right hand in that last round. What do you think of the action you've seen?
The action is going really good. I mean, if you look at the first early round, everyone thought Munguia was going to get the knockout early. I thought he was going to get the stoppage. But then you see Ryder got that second win. I think he just got better and better and he got stronger as the round went on. And with that big shot he caught Munguia with in the last round, I mean, look, it's a 50-50 fight. On points, yeah, you got Munguia up, but at the moment, I think with Ryder coming strong, could still take it. I mean, look, he's got the punch power, and it is a tough fight.
What does he need to do to close the gap?
I think he needs to start putting more pressure, landing them big heavy shots, and sitting down on them big shots as well, and getting that range and that space.
Thanks, Amir.
Great to see Amir Khan here in Phoenix, Arizona. Round 9, scheduled for 12. John Ryder's been down twice, but he's had some success here in the past few rounds. Whoa, and that went straight on the button.
Big shot by Jaime Munguia, came around with an overhand right. Ryder didn't see that coming, right on the top of the head.
Ryder doesn't look good now. The eyes are telling a bad story. John Ryder, can Munguia close the show? Can he do something that Canelo Alvarez couldn't do? Can he stop John Ryder, who goes down again?
Tony Sims is up on the ring apron with the towel, looking to throw it in right now.
Munguia loading up,
and the referee can't see him.
Refuse to throw a towel.